Hi everyone, today we'll analyze about the uses of artificial intelligence techniques in cognitive radio to ascertain the available choices for implementing a practical cognitive radio and the relative merits of various proposed techniques in different applications. Kindly have a look on my previous video where I've discussed in detail about the various artificial intelligence techniques used for cognitive radio. I've given the link of it in the top corner and also in the description box. See to it once, then only it will be easy for you to follow the concept of this video. First, we'll look into the application of artificial neural networks in cognitive radio. Because of their ability to dynamically adapt and be trained at any time, artificial neural networks are able to learn patterns, features and attributes of the system they describe. Here, the term learn refers to the fact that the neurons are stored in computer memory, the outputs of which can systematically be adjusted to yield a new result for a new situation and remember the results. The attributes can be highly nonlinear, complex and numerous. Yet, artificial neural networks can be constructed by only a few examples, thus reducing the complexity of the solution. For this reason, they have long been used to describe functions, processes, or classes that are otherwise difficult to analytically formulate. Therefore, artificial neural networks can be used not only to classify or recognize received stimuli, but to assist in the solution adaptation process as well. ANN has been adopted in spectrum sensing for cognitive radio. An artificial neural network based signal classifier utilizing the extracted cyclostationary signal features was developed earlier. The combination of cyclostationary analysis and ANN provides efficient and reliable signal classification and reduces the online processing time by performing a significant amount of computation offline. Further, ANN is used to classify different IEEE 802.11 signals, that is, the complementary code keying signal and the orthogonal frequency division multiplexing signal, based on the frequency features. We also observe that ANN-based spectrum sensing algorithms are evaluated for wireless mesh networks, where the simulation results show that the ANN-based algorithm achieves better performance in accuracy and speed than the Bayesian-based algorithm. Further, artificial neural network has also been used for radio parameter adaptation in cognitive radio. A cognitive radio testbed has been developed using Tektronix test equipment as RF hardware and a personal computer running open source SCA implementation for different waveforms. The artificial neural network determines radio parameters for given channel states with three optimization goals, which includes meeting the bit error rate, maximizing the throughput, and minimizing the transmit power. Artificial neural network based distributed optimization algorithm has been proposed for large-scale cognitive wireless clouds, which consists of many heterogeneous terminals and networks. Further, ANN are also used to characterize the real-time achievable communication performance in cognitive radio. Since the characterization is based on runtime measurement, it provides certain learning capability that can be exploited by the cognitive engine. The simulation results attest good modeling accuracy and flexibility in various applications and scenarios. In addition, artificial neural network has been used for pattern classification in pattern-based transmission for cognitive radio, where the transmission bit string is mapped to a signal pattern at the transmitter and the received pattern is classified and mapped back to a bit string at the receiver using artificial neural network. Next, we'll look into the application of hidden Markov model in cognitive radio. Hidden Markov model can be built for a specific system to explain and characterize the occurrence of the observed symbols or patterns. This model can then be used to identify the sequences of observations with the same pattern by choosing the model that would most likely produce the observed sequences. Therefore, hidden Markov model can be used as an observation process of the cognitive engine to recognize or classify received stimuli and can achieve awareness. In addition, since it can reproduce the training sequences, it can be used for prediction. Furthermore, learning can be accomplished by creating new models. Next, hidden Markov models have been applied to cognitive radio research. HMM is trained using genetic algorithm with data from a broadband channel sounder in a line of sight additive white Gaussian noise channel. Authors has proposed to model wireless channel online using HMM for cognitive radio. Further, HMMs have also been used for spectrum sensing in cognitive radio. HMM is used to process signal cyclostationary features for primary signal detection in cognitive radio. The HMM-based spectrum sensing approach can detect and classify signals at low SNRs, with only limited information on signal bandwidth. Few authors also validate the existence of a Markov chain model for wireless channel utilization with real-time measured data in the paging band and formulate the spectrum sensing problem using hidden Markov model. In addition, hidden Markov models have been used for spectrum occupancy prediction. Hidden Markov model-based dynamic spectrum access algorithm has been developed where the HMM models and predicts the spectrum occupancy of the licensed radio bands for cognitive radio networks. This HMM-based dynamic spectrum access algorithm can achieve significant signal-to-noise ratio improvement compared with the traditional carrier-sense multiple access-based approach. Next comes the application of metaheuristic algorithms in cognitive radio. The metaheuristic techniques are not only be used for reasoning or finding the optimal solution with objective or utility function, but can also be used for learning with the aid of training examples when the relationship between parameters and the desired performance measure is not well understood. The objective of learning is to identify a hypothesis or a rule set from the search space that maximizes the fit of the training examples to the target concept. Or, in other words, to identify a hypothesis set or a set of rules that is consistent with the training examples. Although the characteristics of each search algorithm are different, a common challenge in the application of metaheuristic techniques is the formulation of extensive examples for target scenarios. Among the various metaheuristic algorithms, genetic algorithm has been widely adopted to solve multi-objective optimization problem and dynamically configure cognitive radio in response to the changing wireless environment. Genetic algorithm is applied to adapt the radio parameters of software-defined radio to the changing radio environment. In their implementation, the fitness function dynamically links and weights different objects according to the link conditions and user application requirements. Further, a genetic algorithm-based cognitive engine is designed to control the radio parameters for single-carrier and multi-carrier transceivers. Next, a set of fitness functions have been derived to guide the search direction of genetic algorithm and investigate the trade-off between the convergence time and the size of the genetic algorithm search space. Genetic algorithm is used to adapt the parameters of cognitive radios on autonomous vehicles. These autonomous vehicles form a geographically varying dynamic wireless network for communication and information sharing among the vehicles and the base station. Many authors validate the applicability of genetic algorithm-based radio parameter adaptation for the CDMA 2000 forward link in a realistic scenario with Ricksian fading. Investigations also attest that a genetic algorithm-based cell-by-cell dynamic spectrum allocation scheme achieves better spectral efficiency than the fixed spectrum allocation scheme. A new solution encoding technique is proposed to reduce the genetic algorithm convergence time. Further, a software testbed for cognitive radio with spectrum sensing capability and a genetic algorithm-based cognitive engine to optimize radio parameters for dynamic spectrum access has been implemented. Next comes the application of rule-based systems in cognitive radio. The most significant advantage of rule-based system is its simplicity. A radio can deduce actions for an input quickly using RBS. With proper domain knowledge, the rule base can automatically or manually be built. During the rule derivation process, relevant and irrelevant features can be handled differently for a rule. However, this process is usually tedious for a complex domain. The accuracy of RBS depends on the completeness and accuracy of the underlying rule base. If the domain is not perfectly understood, then RBS might return inappropriate responses. This is often the case for some cognitive radio applications like dynamic spectrum access. One possible solution to this issue is to assign certainty values to rules and make use of statistical tools such as Bayesian analysis. Although this approach leads to a less rigorous conclusion, it could provide a good guess for situations that are not perfectly understood. Another choice can be to combine the RBS with case-based system and make use of experience to compensate for the inaccuracy in RBS. Next, the rule-based reasoning cognitive engine, that is RBRCE, has been designed for cognitive radio. It has been designed and evaluated for IEEE 802.22 Wireless Rural Area Network, that is WRAN applications. The developed RBR cognitive engine can achieve similar performance as that of the cognitive engine based on genetic algorithm with a lower computational complexity. Further, RBR cognitive engine using predicate calculus has also been developed, focusing on a generic cognitive radio architecture enabling learning in the reasoning process. Learning results are expressed in predicate calculus and can therefore be used in cognitive engine. The operation of cognitive engine is demonstrated for capacity maximization and dynamic spectrum access problems. Fundamental of any rule-based reasoning system is the generation of rule database. A systematic method was developed to derive the rule database through automatic experiments over a vast parameter space using statistical analysis of variance and design of experiments. Important parameters across the protocol layers and relationships between parameters and performance metrics are identified and modeled through the experiments. Based on the extracted rules, optimal configuration can be drawn for specific channel conditions and application requirements. Now we'll see the application of ontology-based systems in cognitive radio. Using ontology languages, ontology-based system is able to logically deduce facts. A radio equipped with OBS can understand the capability and characteristics of itself and other radios using logic deduction. This understanding, as well as the understanding of the environment, helps the radio to deduce optimal operating parameters. Note that the logic derivation in the inference engine might be impractically long, which means that some derivation cannot be completed within a finite amount of time. Ontology language has been investigated for cognitive radio development. We need to understand that a good language for cognitive radio should have the capability to express rules, introduce new functions, and specify radio behaviors. An important example is the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency's Next Generation Policy Language Framework. This framework is based on an extensible ontological framework to facilitate future extension of spectrum rules and related concepts. It allows both regulatory and system policies to be expressed and enforced. Ontology-based reasoning, that is OBR, is used to achieve self-awareness and interoperability among SDR nodes.
with an example on radios negotiating an equalizer training sequence structure, we observe that self-awareness can improve the interoperability of SDRs. Further, Web Ontology Language, that is OWL, is used in OBR. In addition to self-awareness and interoperability, OBR is also used to apply spectrum policy to dynamic spectrum access. A prototype framework is built for cognitive radio using OBR. Ontologies and rules are combined to achieve a knowledge-driven differential response capability, which is said to be the capability of reasoning about a failure in an attempt and identifying alternative actions to satisfy the goal using knowledge of the radio technology, policy, goals, and other contextual information. In other words, the cognitive engine learns from its failures and avoids the same failures in the future.
Last comes the application of case-based systems in cognitive radio. For a given environment and radio objectives, a cognitive radio can use a case database to determine an acceptable solution or action for the current environment based on the existing case in a case database. As case database may not include all possible situations, a cognitive radio may encounter some issues in operation. So, a cognitive radio needs to learn new cases when it encounters new situations, generate new actions for the new situations, and update the case database with the new cases. These are the general tasks of case-based system or case-based reasoning in cognitive radio. Case-based reasoning has recently been investigated for cognitive engine design. A CBR-based cognitive engine is designed to obtain radio parameters for IEEE 802.22 WRAN applications. The performance of the CBR cognitive engine is evaluated under various radio scenarios and compared to several multi-objective optimization-only algorithms, including hill climbing search and genetic algorithm. The simulation results show that the CBR cognitive engine can achieve comparable performance with less complexity after appropriate training or learning. Further, a cognitive engine using case-based reasoning and fuzzy logic has been designed to determine the channel type for WiMAX systems. Later, a cognitive engine architecture has also been proposed for the use of case-based reasoning in cognitive engine. The functionalities of the building blocks in the cognition cycle and the cognitive engine are analyzed, which includes environmental awareness, case-based learning, multi-objective optimization, and hardware-portable interface. Further, the implementation of the building blocks has also been suggested. Thank you for watching this video. If you find this video to be useful, kindly subscribe it and share it with your friends. Don't forget to click that like button because it will motivate me to post more videos. If you want me to analyze any special or specific topic, kindly let me know in the comment section. Bye, take care.